morning. You're watching PA Harness Week. I'm Charlotte McBride. It is Derby Day in Kentucky, but if you weren't able to make it to the Bluegrass State, there's a lot of partying going on right here in Harris, Philadelphia, and up in the Poconos. We'll give you the details on that coming up, and here's what you can expect to see in this next half hour. Get your hats. It's Derby time, and the party is on in the Poconos. The world's richest harness horse was also in the Poconos. Would there be an upset? And it's all over for the blue chip matchmaker and Levy legs. We'll head to Yonkers coming up. All right, my pick to win the Kentucky Derby is the undefeated Dortmund. Heather and Steve will have their picks coming up later. It's racing's fastest paced half hour, and it all starts right now on Comcast Sportsnet.
They're off.
Kim Basabi, welcome to PA Harness Week. She's Heather Vitale, I'm Steve Ross, and as you can tell by the skimmers adorning our heads, this is Derby Day. Heather's got hers on, I've got mine on, and we are ready for the Kentucky Derby, aren't we, babe?
Yours looks so good.
Yours, I mean, the folks out there can take a look. I mean, is that skimmer happening or what?
Thank you. I worked really hard on this Derby hat, you know.
As I did with mine.
Yeah. Okay.
Good stuff. Amazing stuff going on at both venues, Pocono and here. Heather, what's going on at Pocono this exciting, this Derby Day?
Yeah, and first of all, everybody should know there is a doubleheader at Pocono today. Live racing starts at 11 a.m. That's the first card.
Breakfast at Pocono?
Yes. And they're going to have all kinds of great things going on. Of course, the big Kentucky Derby hat contest.
Ooh, that's always great.
It's huge, very popular. They also have like this really cool like souvenir photo booth there. They have $10 souvenir betting vouchers, all kinds of great things happening at Pocono. Oh, and I should mention when the next card starts, because I said it was a doubleheader. Now, the big Kentucky Derby race, which you will be able to see there on big screens, it goes off at 6:24. So then right after the Derby's over, the second card for harness racing at Pocono will start.
Wow.
Yeah.
The only question is Jen Starr at Pocono going to wear two different hats for the day card and the night card?
I think she usually does.
I think she does,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, you should just go to Pocono just to see her change hats because they're spectacular.
Okay. Harris, Philadelphia is not to be left out of the mix. Big doings going on right here. What's going on, Heather?
Yeah, okay, wow. There's a big cook-off happening, lots of food during the day. Live entertainment, which is always, I mean, you love coming to the track for live entertainment. But the post time starts at 12:40 here at Harris, Philadelphia. You know, so you want to get here for the first race and take in all the festivities. They're also having a hat contest and a fashion show. Oh, you know?
He stole my heart.
Yeah, I know. There's a lot of really great things happening at both tracks. I'm super excited. Yeah.
So get out and come either to Pocono. We're here at Harris, okay? It's amazing stuff. And the Kentucky Derby and the annual prayer vigil by the Thoroughbred people saying, please, we need a triple crown winner. Can this be the year, please?
I think it will be the year. Do you want to know who my Derby pick is? Or?
Well, don't tell anybody. Let's tease them till the end. What do you think?
Oh!
I say tease it till the end.
You are thinking right off the bat today.
Wow.
Hello.
All right, let's get to the racing action, shall we? Race 10 at Pocono on Saturday night was the feature race. Not only was it the feature, it featured the richest harness horse in history. And they wanted to find out what they still had left in the tank, I think. Right, Heather?
Yeah, okay, so you're talking about, of course, number one in here who is foiled again. And actually, he ends up being the better's choice as well. Now, he's 11 years old, and he is the richest harness horse in harness racing history with almost $7 million in the bank. And I thought this was an interesting fact. This just shows his grit and durability over the years. Jim Bevilier put this in a press release. Okay, so it's been... Since Foiled Again's first start at Pocono, it's been 2,780 days since his very first start at Pocono when he was a three-year-old. So that just shows you, man, that guy's really gritted it out. Of course, Freehold again, the favorite. But, you know, you cannot discount number two. It's Sparky Mark. The Allard brothers here team up. Trainer Renee Allard with driver Simon Allard. I never can overlook them.
Sparky Mark has been rock solid of late and has the edge now for Simon Allard by a length. Luck Be Withyou. Big earner is a 2- and 3-year-old. Now gets a taste of the older horses for the first time with a pocket seat for Anthony Napolitano. And then there's Foiled again. Biggest earner on the planet. His first appearance at Pocono this year. He's the 6-5 favorite third. Nobody making a move to the outside, surprisingly there, allowing Sparky Mark the lead. Ideal Matters fourth, then O'Sunland, and the trailer is Bolt the Door. Half is 55 even, 28-2 second panel. Very reasonable for these. It's Sparky Mark. Allard not asking a thing. He looks back. Now he knows Luck Be Withyou is right behind him there in the pocket. On the inside, Foiled again, still content to save ground. To the outside, Ideal Matters, and now Foiled again steps out first over. Ideal Matters with the cover there behind him. O'Sunland moves up fifth, and the trailer Bolt the Door. Three quarters, 122-4, 27-4 third panel. It's still Sparky Mark, and Allard still has an ass. He's up by a length. Luck Be Withyou is lurking. Foiled again on the outside, not coming on. Top of the stretch, Sparky Mark by a length. Here comes Luck Be Withyou out of the pocket. It's Luck Be Withyou on the outside. Sparky Mark digging in on the inside. Luck Be Withyou, Sparky Mark, Sparky Mark.
Sparky Mark goes gate to wire and wins at 149-2. As I said before the race, the horse is driven by Simon Allard, trained by his brother, Renee Allard. They are red hot. I mean, actually, what's hotter than red hot? Is it white hot? White hot. They are white hot. There you go.
Foiled again hot.
Oh, no. Dude, don't go there. Okay, just hold on. I'm getting there, man. I don't even want to talk about that, but I will. All right. The Sparky Mark, by the way, pays 14.20. Luck Be Withyou, a former Breeders' Crown champ. He was second. Oh, Sunland was third. Bolt the Door was fourth. And yes, Foiled again was fifth. He did try to make a first up move, you know, just I'm not sure what the deal is. Maybe he's just like, you know what? I got nothing to prove, y'all. I'm just going to come here, show up. You're going to bet me, and I'm going to be like, whatever.
You think Foiled again said, y'all? You think?
He spent his winter in, like, North Carolina,
oh, really?
So you never know.
So he picked
know.
Up the Southern accent. But the other thing is it may be in the beginning of the year, Yannick said that he was old and fat.
Oh, I know. Thanks a lot, Yannick.
Yeah, Yannick put the kibosh on him.
Yeah, exactly.
So now he's a total head case. Oh, my God, I'm over. Can't race anymore. Help me, please.
Oh, you know who is not old and fat?
Who?
Sharla McBride.
Oh, she caught up, right?
Yes, she caught up.
To find out what the deal is.
With Simon Allard.
All right, thanks so much, guys. I'm here with driver Simon Allard. Simon, a huge weekend last weekend for you at Pocono with Sparky Mark. Tell me about that night.
That was a pretty good night. I didn't expect to win that race because those horses, like Luck Be Withyou and Bolt the Door, are pretty nice horses, and Foiled again, but I guess they were not all in their great form. You know, one was off a few were coming from a qualifier, and Foiled got probably was racing tough at Yonkers, so, and he's getting a little older, so my horse got away with a cheap half, and he got it done. He just a nice horse.
You mentioned those horses that you beat. Luck Be Withyou, Bolt the Door, Foiled again. It'd be nice if you beat one of those horses. That'd be a good night. But you beat all three. So what were you feeling at the end of the night?
It's like driving a long shot that you didn't expect, you know? Like every night we always drive horses that you think you're going to win easy. And sometimes you don't. And sometimes you drive horses that are a long shot and you do win. Like it was a good feeling. It's always great to win a race that you're not expecting.
That Pocono track has been kind to you. It's the 50th anniversary of the Downs at Pocono. What is special about that track to you?
I only been there for a few years, but I adapt myself pretty quick to that track because it's all about speed. You always get away close, and I always been good at leaving the gate. So I enjoy it, and it's such a nice track, and horse stays sound and. It's great for owners or a trainer that invest money into horses. Usually horses never get hurt over that track. You know, it happens a little bit, but less than most of any other track in the world, I think.
Perfect. Well, yeah. We wish you the best of luck going forward, and we hope to see more of you.
Yeah, thank you.
Back to you guys.
about it. What do you think about Foiled Again? I don't know either. But stick around when we come back. More racing action. Pocono, it will be in your face, and it will be no disgrace.
Life. It all comes down to the things you do. The places you see. The people you meet. It's all of the beautiful things. The incredible things. And the spectacular things that makes us feel unexplainable things. Life is going on. All you have to do is choose to live it. Full of Life, Mohegan Sun Pocono.
There and welcome back. This is PA Harness Week. She's Heather. I'm Steve, and we got action aplenty on this Derby Day. Saturday's opener at Pocono, a condition pace. Non-winners to $21,000 in the last five starts. $22,000 on the line. Number two, Roger Mockham, with Georgie Knapp was even money. Number one, Mustang Art was a 6-5 second choice with Jim Morrill Jr. Number three, Lone Wolf Courier with Matt Kincaid. He was 4-1. And here's the call.
First time past the faithful tonight, and Roger Mockham not getting it easy there as Bacon on the Beach strung him out pretty well. The even money favorite struggling to get to the front, and now he's got another challenge because here comes Mustang Art, who's been racing well, and he takes the lead now for Jim Morrill Jr. Bacon on the Beach, meanwhile, shuffled back to third, followed by the Lone Wolf Courier, fresh off a win at Harris fourth. Mosee Terror is fifth, and then Feels Like Magic. The half 53-3, 26-4 second panel. That's a good way to start the night here. Mustang Art delivering eye-popping fractions to the half-mile marker, leads it now by a length. It's Roger Mockham settled in the pocket. Here comes Lone Wolf Courier, first over for Matt Kakaley and gaining. Mosee Terror picks up that live cover. Bacon on the Beach is fifth, but only two away. It feels like Magic has a shot, especially with his solid late kick. Three quarters reached 121-3, 28 even. Third panel, absolutely no let-up, and now Mustang Art might be feeling the effects because Lone Wolf Courier is right there with him. Meanwhile, second over, Mosee Terror in prime pouncing position. Top of the stretch, Lone Wolf Courier takes the lead away from Mustang Art. Inside, Roger Mockham trying to come out again. Outside, Mosee Terror looking to kick the cover. Mosee Terror at 30-1 is surging. Mosee Terror!
Mustang Art cut the splits. Roger Mockham in the two-hole. Lone Wolf Courier came first up, while giving Mosee Terror a 30-1 shot with Marcus Miller, a perfect second over trip behind him. Mosee Terror, I know it doesn't sound like a name you would be scared of. Mosee? I'm scared of Mosee. Mosee Terror.
Woo!
Managed to get to the wire first, springing the upset in 149-3 and paying 63 balloons. Roger Mockham was a neck back in second. Lone Wolf Courier, another neck back in third. Saturday's 11th at Pocono, a condition pace. Non-winners at 12, making $15,200 in the last five starts. 18 dimes on the line. Number nine, Major Deegan, with Jim Morrill Jr., was 3-2. Number five, Maytime Terror, with Georgie Knapp. And number three, Diamond Cowboy, with Simon Allard. We're both 5-2, and here's that call.
They're hopping on the front end here. Major Deegan, an impressive win last time out in come from behind fashion, but tonight makes the lead as they pass the pond with Jim Morrill Jr. in the bike. Make Time Terror also coming off a win, sits the pocket behind the 3-2 favorite Major Deegan. On the inside, It's That Time is third, followed by Sylvester Stallion, and now Diamond Cowboy first over, leaving there for Simon Allard. Following that is Humility second over at the back, Feeling Funky and Stonehouse Adam. Half mile reached 55-2, 28-4 second panel. Major Deegan with the lead. On the outside, Diamond Cowboy making a strong move towards the front, but Major Deegan speeding up once again is keeping that one off his back. In the pocket there, Maytime Terror. Humility is second over and sneaking up behind his cover. Boxed in fifth, It's That Time. Third over, Feeling Funky is sixth. And then further back, Sylvester Stallion and Stonehouse Adam. It is tight up front, but Major Deegan holding on to the lead. Three quarters, 123 even. 27-3, third panel. Major Deegan trying to fend off the persistent pressure of Diamond Cowboy. Maytime Terror, a major threat in the pocket. Further back to Humility, and It's That Time. Top of the stretch, Major Deegan still there. Maytime Terror going to test him in the passing lane now. Outside, Diamond Cowboy not finished chasing either. It's Major Deegan inside Maytime Terror. Outside, Diamond Cowboy. Three of them to the line. Diamond Cowboy.
Wow. Well, talk about a blanket finish. Five of them on the wire, separated by three noses, a head, and a neck. Diamond Cowboy nosed Major Deegan in 115.4. Maytime Terror was another nose back in third. Woo, what a heat that was. When we come back, it was Miller's Day at Harris. Don't go away.
Late Night Choke is out. Ryan Kaylee's shaking bank in between. Here comes Late Night Choke on the outside.
It's showtime. It's all about the action, the odds, the wagers. It's all about who drives who. It's all you need to be part of the action. PA Harness Week, Harness Racing's fastest paced half hour. Saturdays, 10:30 a.m. on Comcast SportsNet Philadelphia. Online at harnessweek.com.
Welcome back to PA Harness Week. She's Heather Vitale. I'm Steve Ross. And as promised, we have more racing action. And if you're into brewskis, this is the kind of a day at Harris that was kind of like, I guess we could call it Miller time. Couldn't we have, huh?
We could do that.
We could do that, couldn't we?
Brewskis. Yeah, that's very late 80s of you to say.
I remember the late 80s, believe it or not.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, let's get into the race. Now, winners of 10,000 last five starts to purses $13,000. Number three is Papa Ray. This is a tough horse. He was racing and was a top contender in the big races at Dover Downs during the winter. Then there's number seven, and that's the Rich Ringler trainee, Simon's Artist, not to be confused with
Simon Says?
No, you're close.
Yes.
Artist Rally.
Oh, okay.
Who's the number four horse in here?
As Artist Rally looks to clear, back to fifth, Papa Ray around the turn. And with the clearing move up on the outside, Artist Rally crosses over. JetBlue Miracle Supply in the new competition. Simon's Artist is back to third. A length better than Papa Ray has been wheeled up into it fourth now. Hide Me Away strapped to the inside of an advancing PH power play. 55 and four as they race up the bank's trench. Painfully cool, trapped in sixth and moving to the outside. Rusty's no fool. Four in, four out. It was a busy first half, and the action continues. Inside Artist Rally. On the outside, JetBlue Miracle. These two at one another with Simon's Artist tightening down in the pocket third. Papa Ray's given his cue now. Moves out three wide. Inside, Hide Me Away. Three quarters, 124. Up on the outside, Papa Ray now on the scene. Up the challenge, Artist Rally as JetBlue Miracle drops back. The H Power plays advancing three wide towards the inside. Simon's Artist starts to fail. They straighten the way for the stretch drive. And up on the outside, Papa Ray inside. Artist Rally is game, though. These two going at it. Artist Rally on the inside. Papa Ray on the outside. Artist Rally holding together to the finish.
Artist Rally sets up all the teletimers, including the last one, of course, in the time of a 152. JetBlue Miracle, he was challenging a little bit first up there. Papa Ray, he made a bid, but Artist Rally is just like, catch me if you can, but you can't, not today. The nine-year-old wins with Andy Miller in the sulky. Miller, remember that name? They win payoff 1240. Papa Ray was second, and third was Simon's Artist.
You think we're done? We're not. Sunday 7th at Harris Philly. Condition pace, non-winners, $26,000. Last five, $22,000 on the line. Number two, Adventure Bound with Corey Callahan, was odds on at 3-5. Number three, Something in the Wind was 7-2 with Georgie Knapp. Number seven, Kaylee's Shake and Bake. I love that name. With Scott Zeron was 5-1. And Mike Bozich has that call for you.
But up on the outside, Adventure Bound forces the lead chain. Something in the Wind back to second. Bullet Bob is third by two lengths, better than you is fourth. A length and a half back to Sam Destin Hanover. Kaylee's Shake and Bake's on the move from last. Late Night Choke, the new trailer. Around the clubhouse turn they go, eight lengths front from back. The lead belongs to Adventure Bound, and the advantage is one over Something in the Wind. 55-3 for the half, 28-1 for quarter two. Kaylee's Shake and Bake rolling up on the outside, uncovered third now. Bullet Bomb getting shuffled in fourth. Up on the outside, Late Night Choke advancing with sharp moving cover. Better than you, shuffled back to sixth. On the move from the bank is Sam Destin Hanover as they make their way towards three quarters. Adventure Bound leads it by a half. Kaylee's Shake and Bake, a long uncovered grind into second. Something in the Wind on the inside third. Up on the outside, Late Night Choke still latched on to cover fourth. Three quarters, 123-2. The top of the stretch, Adventure Bound leads leads by a long neck. Outside, Kaylee Shake and Bake. Moving three wide is Late Night Joke. Something in the Wind awaiting clearance. They straighten the way for the stretch drive. Adventure Bound. Late Night Joke is out wide. Kaylee Shake and Bake in between. Here comes Late Night Joke on the outside, taking the lead.
Adventure Bound, quarter pole and took the lead. Meanwhile, Kaylee Shake and Bake came first up and towing along. Number five, Late Night Joke, a 24-1 bomber with Brett Miller, who springboarded, like that word, off the live cover to get up in 151-4. Adventure Bound held second. Something in the Wind smelled up third.
This is the recap of the day. Brett Miller wins four on the card. Andy Miller wins one. David Miller wins one. Marcus Miller didn't win any, but he finished second like three times. So good effort.
So it was Miller time. Definitely,
yeah,
right?
Definitely.
We did not lie, okay? Good stuff. When we come back, well, you've gone through all the legs. They've had more legs than a giant tarantula. But finally, the finals are here. We're going to see the finals of the Blue Chip Matchmaker and the Levy from Yonkers coming up next. Don't you dare think about going anywhere.
The Levy final at the inside. It's PH Supercam taken on by Luke Can Hanover.
Life. It all comes down to the things you do. The places you see. The people you meet. It's all of the beautiful things. The incredible things. And the spectacular things. That makes us feel unexplainable things. Life is going on. All you have to do is choose to live it. Full of Life. Mohegan Sun Pocono.
Welcome back to PA Harness Week. Harness Racing's fastest paced half hour. I thought I'd throw that in because we're here.
You haven't said it in a while either.
No.
People need to be reminded.
It was time. You guys got that, right? Okay, good. Let's go to Yonkers. Race 6 was the final of the Blue Chip Matchmaker. Boy, these high-class ladies. Check this out. Two entries took all the money in this heat. Number 2, You're Gonna Kiss Me or Not with Brian Sears. And 2A, Carol's Ideal with Danny Dubé. We're odds on at 1-2. Number 1, Venus Delight with Jason Bartlett. And Crispy Apple with Tim Tietrich. We're 9-5. The rest all double-digit bombers. And John Vernon has that call.
They went the opening quarter in 27 seconds flat. On the far turn the first time, and Sears and You're Gonna Kiss Me or Not. Sears having a big night tonight as he shoots for 5 on the card. Venus Delight now relegated to the pocket, followed in third toward the inside. That's Fancy Desire. Carol's Ideal has been given her cue, and she's looking for 5 in a row, and Carol's Ideal moves to the outside, going to be followed by Brett Miller and Monkey on My Wheel. Down toward the inside is Long Shot Strings, and then third over is Crispy Apple. She's drawn within 5.5 lengths of the lead. And Camille trails to a half mile in 56-1, 29-1 second quarter. But the field takes close order with half mile to go in this Blue Chip Matchmaker Series in the entry 1-2 here. At the inside, You're Gonna Kiss Me or Not, and Carol's Ideal come to take on her parimutuel partner. Toward the inside, it's Venus Delight third. Monkey on My Wheel is honing in second over at fourth at 20-1. Fifth toward the inside is a bottled up Fancy Desire. Crispy Apple's right there in the vanguard. Down to the inside is Strings and Camille in a wide open affair. 3/4 and 1, 24-4, 28-3, third quarter on the final turn in the Blue Chip Matchmaker Series final, and they're doing battle. You're Gonna Kiss Me or Not. Carol's Ideal shoulder to shoulder on the inside. Venus Delight on the far outside, coming alive. Crispy Apple from between horses is Monkey on My Wheel. You're Gonna Kiss Me or Not. Here's Venus Delight on the inside.
This one became a high stakes Harry Carey match between two stablemates, huh? With You're Gonna Kiss Me or Not and Carol's Ideal slugging it out from the half, neither one giving an inch. Meanwhile, Venus Delight sat chilly in the garden spot waiting to pounce and finally did, winning a length in 153-4, making 152-4. You're Gonna Kiss Me or Not stubbornly held the belly with Carol's Ideal third in the consolation. Number 5 for the ladies off at 5-1 with Brian Sears got the money in 153-1. And now,
wait, I want to mention one thing about the Blue Chip. Camille didn't do very well in the final, but guess what?
What?
She's done racing, she's retired, and she's going to make a babies with Sweet Lou.
Ooh,
like,
nice.
Yeah, I know.
Thank you for that.
A little update.
All right, you guys waited long enough. It's time for the $500,000-plus Levy final. And Heather's got it for you.
I do. Okay. $529,000 is the purse. Number 6 is Take It Back Terry. He's the favorite. He's won a three races in a row. Okay, but two of them in 151 and a piece. And if you do not know, on a half mile, yeah, that's relatively fast, I would say, okay? The one in the 1A, there's an entry of Makaso, he's got the seven hole, and then PH Supercam, been undefeated in the series so far, and the defending champ, but he's got the eight hole.
PH Supercam has taken the lead up the backstretch, then Do Me That Again and Luke Canhaliver in third, a gap of two, then to Windsong Jack in fourth. Beach Memories fifth, six lengths from the lead on the shadow of the quarter pole. And then comes Take It Back Terry. The trailers in the field are Palake and Mock It So is the trailer, nine lengths from his paramutual partner who's setting the pace, opening quarter 27-2. PH Supercam cleared the top and cleared it easily tonight, leads it by two. Sitting the pocket is Do Me That Again, and Luke Canhaliver sizing up the leader from third. Long shot, Windsong Jack is fourth toward the inside, and now moving to the outside. Here comes Beach Memories, and Jingra gets the cover as Dave Miller slid out with Luke Canhaliver. Third over is Take It Back Terry in good striking position. A gap of three to Palake and the trailer, Mock It So. The half mile was 55-3. 28-1 second quarters. They approach the backstretch. In the Levy final at the inside, it's PH Supercam taken on by Luke Canhaliver. And knocking on the door is Beach Memories right there, a threatening third. Toward the inside, fourth is Do Me That Again. Third over fifth, Brennan and Take It Back Terry in a wide open affair. Down toward the inside, Windsong Jack, PH Supercam under siege here. Three quarters and 1:23 on the final turn. PH Supercam outside, Luke Canhaliver. Toward the inside, third is Do Me That Again. Moving on the far outside, Beach Memories has to do better. Going to kick in on the far outside, Take It Back Terry. Windsong Jack's behind rivals. PH Supercam fully extended on the inside. Here comes Do Me That Again. Between horses, Luke Canhaliver way out wide. Take It Back Terry. Do Me That Again takes the Levy final.
Location, location, location. And when I say location, I mean like the two hole. Around the Yonkers Oval.
Are we talking right? Real estate here, or horse racing?
We're talking this Do Me That Again. Okay. Got a winning trip. It was heavenly. Okay, 151-1. Dan Dubé in the sulky for Rene Allard. PH Superman, he tried to cut the mile, busted right out of the eight hole. No shame in his game. I mean, he faded to fourth, but he was challenged in the mile. Take It Back Terry, second. Beach Memories was third. By the way, there was a consolation. I do want to mention that Sapphire City, as you would say,
Do-wa-diddy.
Yeah, he ended up winning the consolation, 152-2. Paid $30 with Mark McDonald in the sulky.
All right, let's go over to Freehold for the Dexter Cup Elim. It was a goodie. The race Nick, your entry was favored at 6-5, but getting the money was Apollo's Creed. Nylon. It's not Apostles Creed. Not related to Apollo's Creed, but you would think it was related.
Oh my gosh! Every time I saw the horse's name, that's what I was
you
reading.
Apollo's Creed. Well, anyway, Apollo's Creed won the race, paid $11, and beat Divisionalist. So we'll have a final coming up. We'll have that for you here, of course, on PA Harness Week. And now it's time for our Derby picks, Heather.
Okay.
Why don't you just whip yours on the folks?
Okay, I'm going with American Pharoah, and I swear it is not
chalk
because it's not because he's a chalk. I'm not even picking him because he's good. I'm picking him because he's known as the cuddly horse. He's very friendly and sweet, such as I. And also, I just got my hair cut, and he's known for his short tail. He has kind of a short tail, so I'm like feeling that. I feel like your Derby pick should be a horse you really resonate with.
Okay, I think Dortmund can't win. He's got a bad name. Horses with bad names cannot win the Derby. I do like American Pharoah, but it depends upon what's going to happen there. But I want to make an oddball pick. I want to pick Ocho, 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 and I want to pick him to finish eighth. And that's going to do it for this edition of PA Harness Week. For all of us here, Bruce Casella, Sharla McBride, Heather Vitale, I'm Steve Ross, reminding you to pick up the pace just a taste and get yourself high on harness.
It's only natural.